whether it's because of spring cleaning or turn of a new year, from time to time, you may want to update your website. Now, before you go and look for a new template or start tweaking the fonts and the colors, I would like to suggest looking at your website from this perspective. The perspective of your number one goal. Hi, my name is Sophia Oja, and in this video, I want to present to you one example of a website that achieves its primary goal effectively. When you're sitting down to update your website, you may be tempted to change the fonts and colors or switch over the photographs to give a boost to your website, to refresh your site. But the perspective that I want you to look at your website from is whether or not it is achieving your primary goal for this online asset. After all, your website is an online business asset. It's meant to achieve the goals that you have outlined for it. So what is important is to first clearly identify what the primary goal of your website is, especially since a website can do so many things. It can build your email list, it can position you as an expert and an authority in your field, it can present your portfolio, your case studies, can generate revenue, can get you new students and clients. So it's really important that in this portfolio of all the things that your website can do, what is the one thing that you want it to accomplish? Now, authors are experts at editing. Whether or not they like to do it, they understand the importance of it, and they get a team that will help them to edit their work. And so who better to be inspired from than an author website? Today, I want to show you the site of James Clear. Let's hop on over to jamesclear.com, and I'll show you a couple of things that I loved about his site and how I think it accomplishes the number one goal that I perceive is of the website for this author. So let's jump right in. So here we are on jamesclear.com on the homepage. And right away, you notice that James Clear is the author of Atomic Habits. The image of the book is prominent right in the center. The positioning is inescapable. Also hard to miss is the opt-in form, which from a marketing perspective seems to be the number one function that I notice throughout this website. From a value perspective, it's very obvious to me that giving valuable content to the readers is the number one goal of the site. Also notice the ample use of white space or negative space. The screen is not jam-packed with content, one of the hallmarks of minimalist design. Lots of margin, as one would say in book design, and a healthy headroom, as would be described in filmmaking. Plus, notice the short sentences that take up no more than two lines each. Now let's go over to books. Not only is the book on the home page, it also is the first link in the top navigation. When you click books and land on the books page, you recognize the Atomic Habits book and you learn of the Clear Habit Journal. And both of these books have buttons with a call to action where the visitor is invited to go deeper and learn more. And that is all that you see on this page. More is not really needed. Now let's go on to the About page. I really like this content here above the fold. Notice that instead of diving into a long form author bio, what you see is a short bio, which does two things. One, it lets you know that James Clear is the author of Atomic Habits, and two, invites you to the newsletter sign up. Then on the right, you see a quick snapshot of some of the things that he wants you to know. And for me, a new piece of information here I see is that he's the host of the James Clear Show, So I'm now intrigued and want to know more about this show. And then you learn more about him throughout this page. And here at the bottom, you see an opt-in form to build his email list. One final thing I want to point out is about the footer, which is very succinct and neatly presented. I like it very much. Plus, notice that we only see two social media links, which I take as encouragement to pick one or two social media platforms instead of trying to be on multiple platforms. If you looked at the other pages like articles and events, you will see a similar sense of coherence. A coherence and simplicity which can be found throughout the website, and it gives a clean look, has a calming effect on the visitor, certainly on me. There are tons of good design decisions on this site and I absolutely love it. It is my hope that you enjoyed this video and can take some insights and tips for your own business website. If you enjoyed this content, please click subscribe and hop on over to sophiaoja.com/live to check out my upcoming live workshops. Thank you for watching and I'll see you next time. Bye.